Wonder Festival 2020, Tokyo, siamo qua con Mr. Shanab per vedere le novità di Figurama Collector. Thank you, Mr. Shanab. Can you tell us more about this year? What do you announce?
So basically, this year is a great year for us. It's an amazing year to start with a high peak, as you know, with the awards that the company have won in 2019. And we are announcing Dragon Ball, as you know,
Wow.
as a license, which it was something very hard to acquire, as well as Claymore, a niche kind of license that it have its own kind of following. And One Punch Man, which
Wow.
is we are going to do something completely different and interesting about it. And as you can see, Rurouni Kenshin, it's the highlight of the beginning of this year, the 25th anniversary official edition. We have, let's say, we have outdone ourselves with this statue in terms of techniques, the materials
Yeah,
that
I
we are
see.
using for the first time, as the die-cast metal and some other effects that it's
Wow.
being applied in. So yeah.
Qui ragazzi, grosse novità, in arrivo Dragon Ball, One Punch e Claymore, e qua abbiamo Kenshin il Vagabondo, come conosciuto in Italia. So, another question, you recently opened an office in Tokyo. Which one is the reason? Is to be more in touch with Japanese company, I suppose.
Basically, all what we do and our business model is like based on the Japanese pop culture. So basically, we want to be closer to this pop culture, to be closer to the people who like work on it in terms of artists, partners, business associates, and so
Yeah,
on.
absolutely.
So basically, we want to be in the heart of it, which is the reason why we have opened in the heart of the anime and
Exactly.
manga and figure
You are in
capital,
Akihabara.
Akihabara. Yes, that's
Quindi
correct.
hanno aperto l'ufficio per essere a contatto con i licensor, con le LP, quindi per essere proprio nel cuore, sono nel cuore di Akihabara, quindi proprio il cuore, diciamo, pop, nerd, geek di Tokyo.
Otaku.
Otaku, esatto. So, you have a lot of fans in Italy, so when you plan to come to look at comics or other comic fair?
Hopefully, we are planning a European visit in the near future. Definitely, our Italian fans, we have a huge fan base. We love them all and definitely would love to be closer to them. So, yeah, it's something that we will definitely be considering in the near future.
Quindi ci stanno pensando ragazzi, quindi non demordete, sicuramente vedremo Figurama Collector presto in Italia. So, let's talk more about this news that I saw that you use a completely new technique on this gorgeous diorama.
Basically, you know, like as I've just mentioned, you know, the metal die cast that we have used in the sword and the complete swappable torso that you can
Yeah.
change the pose because each pose is unique completely. And we have used a guidance from a five dan kendo
Wow.
fighter, which is Mr. Grant,
Ah, yeah, I know him.
our
It's
lawyer. Yeah, definitely. So it was a very interesting project to like work with, and it's something that I'm sure that the fans will appreciate, especially that is the 25th anniversary, and we'll be giving a badge,
Ok,
yeah,
ok.
like a golden patch with it as the
Quindi
object.
questa è stata, diciamo, elaborata con anche un maestro, Quinto Dan di Kendo, che ha dato i suoi consigli, anche perché vedete è una posa molto dinamica, è stato usato il metal diecast, quindi una statua e soprattutto che celebra il 25esimo anniversario di Kenshin il Vagabondo. So, what's next? What is coming? Because I really love what Figurama say that we are the collector.
Exactly. As a collectors, we will keep impressing our fans. We will keep bringing a new vibes to the market. We will keep leading in design and the quality, and we will definitely exceed the expectations of all the collectors in this year.
Great,
And
quindi grosse novità in arrivo.
up.
So, last question,
Yes.
and you recently launched a mini bust, we can say, for Helsing. Any plan, because I really love the idea to have this kind of bust, any idea to produce some, we can say, more affordable product to have more customer base that maybe cannot afford the expensive diorama, but they love the character, they want something in their house.
Absolutely. We definitely want to reach out to all the collectors and fans, no matter like what's their budget or like what's their you know like
Okay.
taste. So like that's the beginning to reach out for such a different kind of a budget, but it, you know, like giving them a piece of the elite line by having it the same details but in a small size. That's something that we are considering with either polystyrene PVC, it doesn't matter, but it's something that we are absolutely.
Quindi ragazzi, grosse novità in arrivo, quindi arriveranno anche prodotti più a prezzi più economici, quindi magari appunto dei piccoli base, dioramine, dei piccoli busti, forse si farà PVC, quindi Figurama Collector sta espandendo anche la propria linea di prodotti. The last one I forgot, it's also made in Abyss. It's a really cool product and I love the idea of light. So tell us more about this.
Yeah. Honestly, this is our first challenge. Yeah. It's one of its kind for us. We wanted to make our point. We wanted to prove that we like don't just do brutal fights or bloody or monsters. We can do a cute. Actually, it's a cute looking, but it's a dark story. At the same time, we wanted to pull the best details in that kind of a theme ever. So that's why you can see the best grass ever. That,
quindi l'idea è quella anche di non soltanto fare diorami, quindi con combattimenti, qualcosa magari di macro, ma anche far vedere che la Figurama Collector è in grado anche di realizzare altri prodotti, quindi, e appunto vedrete come Made in Abyss rispecchia esattamente questo. Thank you very much Mr. Shanab, was a pleasure to collaborate with you and let's get in touch for more and more news.
Grazie mille.
Thank you.
Thank you.